the song we sing in our church. How many have at least one thing to be thankful for? And so put your hands together. He did it all.
Somebody can take it away from me, and I think about when I was in the first grade. It's been many years ago, close to 6 years, and the teacher told me you can't sing, and I know what you mean. So this morning, our anticipation is that when we leave here, we leave this earth, and that we go to heaven, that we're going to fly away.
Amen.
And, so this morning, we're going to try to sing a verse or two of it. I don't know what it's called, a stanza. Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away. When words God's bless the show,
I feel so some of the aches and pain that the old folks feel. I'm not calling you old. But I'm just saying, I feel some of the pain that y'all feel, you know. And back in the day, the old folks said, you just keep living. And they tell you to take care of yourself while you're young, didn't you? Huh? So see, every day, we ought to say, it's another day journey, because I'm made. Because I tell you what, sometimes them pain, they can hurt. They won't let you sleep. They let you have to move and wiggle around, you know. I don't know if y'all got there yet, but I'm getting there, Sister Wood. I feel your pain. Huh? So let's just sing this song, you know. It's another day's journey, and I'm glad. So glad. So glad. Well, it's another day's journey, and I'm glad. And you know that I'm so glad to be here. Let's do it again. Well, it's another day's journey, and I'm glad. So glad.
Thank you.
Y'all hear me, okay? I'm going home on morning train. Ooh, I'm going home on morning train. You know the evening train may be too late. I'm going home on morning train. Well, I'm going home on morning train.
Grandma, Dave, I'm thank our baby for that, what you just said. Amen. Amen. We up to our tithes and offering at this time.
I like Bro Cecil, but I'm not going back that far. Let's keep on time, God.
All right.
He's an on time God. Yes.
Oh,
Amen.
Amen.
Well, it's altar time and it's prayer time, I guess that's what I should say.
Amen.
So much is going on. You can't even listen to the news. Mm-hmm. You know, you try to get something good, every time you listen to the news, you get something bad. Something doesn't happen here, something doesn't happen over there, something happened there. So, man, we ain't gonna be something good. But I'm here today to tell you, God is still is good.
Amen.
You know, I've been sick. I've been down sick for about 3 days. And I'm back on my feet. But thank God for his goodness.
Amen.
You know, I don't know, a lot of times we don't call on him until something happens. But I'm like Paul. He said, when I'm weak, I know my strength.
Mm-hmm.
And see, when I'm weak, I just cry to the Lord. Mm. And I'm learning that when you cry to him, he is our resource.
Mm-hmm.
He is our resource. That's what I should say.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't mind, let us stand and we're going to pray and hope. We pray that the Spirit of God will be in him. And help our pastor this morning. We don't have our musicians. And he needs all the help he can. And so that's what we're here as a family. We're here to pray for him where he can, the Spirit of God will move in him, and we can all be fed this morning. See, I'm learning. I'm a young man, but I'm learning just as much as God gives me. And I learn from my pastor. Let us pray. And let us keep others in prayer, too, those who've been on our prayer list.
Amen.
Eternal Father, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Father, we come right now with thanksgiving in our heart.
Yeah.
First of all, asking you to forgive us of our sins and our shortcomings, O Lord. Father, as we stand here this morning, we bow our head. Then we have thanksgiving in our heart because we know that without you, we couldn't do nothing. We wouldn't even be here, Lord, if it weren't for you. So, Father, as we gather here this morning, we pray, Father God, that you will bind us together in Christian love. Because, Lord, I learned from without a doubt, I love when I get here, Lord, in this sacred place to see my brothers and my sisters here. That I know on this Christian journey, we can't make it by ourselves. We need each other. So, Father, if you will, this morning, we pray for our pastor, Lord, that you will continue to bless him in a mighty special way. And then, Lord, I can't forget about the first lady, Lord.
Yeah.
Because like I'm learning, behind every good man, there's a good woman.
Mm-hmm.
So Father, if you will, continue to bless her in a mighty special way.
Yeah.
And then Father, the family at home,
yeah,
at St. John, we ask you to continue to bless us, Lord.
Yeah.
I know we are small in number, but we're big in heart.
Yeah.
So Father, if you will, continue to bless our auxiliary.
Yeah.
Bless every head of our auxiliary, Lord, that we would get on board and by doing things that you command us to do. And then we will lift this church up, Lord, to you, Lord. Because, Father, we know when you are in the mix, that everything will go according to your will and according to your way. So, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I pray, Lord, that you would just lift this church up and magnify us, Lord, and glorify us, Lord, that we may do the thing that you have called us out to do. Because, Father, one day when it's all said and done down here, we're going to be forever with you, Lord. Every day will be like a Sunday. Every day will be when we can praise your holy and divine name.
Yes.
Father, I just want to say thank you right now.
Thank you, Lord.
But I pray, Father God, for those on the sick list and in those churches all the way around here, all over the world.
Yes.
We pray, Lord God, if you God will, just let your will be done.
Yes.
But when it's all over down here, Lord, we know we got a place to live. We'll be with you ever with you forever.
Yes.
And in Jesus' name we come praying. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask it all. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let the church of the living God say amen again.
Amen.
Indeed, it is a blessing to be in God's house one more time.
Amen.
Let me pray. Eternal God, our Father, which art in heaven, God, we thank you for this day. We thank you, God, for blessing us to be able to get up and move around this morning.
Amen.
We thank you for our health and our strength.
Yes.
Well, first of all, God, we ask, first of all, that you forgive us of our many sins.
Yeah.
Then we pray that you just continue to bless this service in a mighty special way.
Yeah.
Well, thank you all for that's gathered here today in the house of prayer to come to praise your holy and divine name. And to thank you for all of the things that you have done for each and every one of us. We ask that you will bless this country in a mighty special way. Because we need you, God. But we realize that sin is everywhere and man is going against your ways and your wills. We ask that you will have mercy upon us. And then as we go into your service today, we pray that you just bless us. We pray that you bind Satan from our midst. We pray that you use us in a mighty special way. And God, we need you. We know that we need you. So we ask that you just be with us. And then the sick, the shut-ins, as brother prayed, we pray that you just bless them all in a mighty special way. And we thank you, God, and we love you. And then we thank you for the ones who have been sick. And you blessed us to be able to be back into your house one more time. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, God, and I pray that you would just use me in a mighty special way. I pray that you just strip me of self and allow the Spirit to take control and do things which is pleasing to your sight and teach the word. In the name of Jesus, we pray, amen, and thank you, God.
Amen.
In the gospel, according to St. Matthew, the fourth chapter, and I believe we will hear it, I believe Pastor Vidal Ryan preached from this, but I'm going there again, but I'm going in a different way. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
When we get there, we ask that you would look up in on verse number 1. We're going to read verse number 1 through 4, and then we're going to read verse 11. Verses 1 through 4, and then verse 11. Amen?
Amen.
We thank God for each and every one of you who had the opportunity to be with us on last Sunday. Amen.
Amen.
We look at verse 1. It said, then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be, watch this word here, tempted of the devil.
Amen.
And he fasted 40 days and 40 nights. He was afterwards hungered. And when, watch this word again, and when the tempter came to him,
amen,
he said, if thou be the Son of God, command that these stones be made bread.
Amen. Yep.
But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God.
Amen.
Now, if you look at verse 11, it said, then the devil leaveth him, and behold, angels came and ministered unto him.
Amen.
I wanted to tag this today, when enough is enough.
All right.
Is enough. Thank you, ushers.
Should come a time
in our lives that we should see the devil who he really is. And which he is the author of sin. And we should see that the only purpose against God's will.
Amen.
And I was reading the scriptures. By this time, we should know by now that we need to learn how to trust in God and not the devil. By this time, we should know that the devil will do anything that he can to get your attention.
All right. Mm-hmm.
And by this time, we should know that the devil will use anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Use someone else to try to separate you from God.
Mm-hmm.
And when I was reading this, I looked over at John 10 and 10.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah.
And it tells us that the thief cometh not but for to steal,
mm-hmm,
and to kill, and to destroy.
Amen.
And then he goes on to say, I come that they might have life,
amen,
and that they might have it more abundantly.
Yep.
Hear me out, church.
Come on, man.
I want to keep this thing real.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you are a Christian,
right,
if we trust God like we say that we do,
mm-hmm,
then this church and other church to be full on Sunday mornings.
Amen.
And then we'll stop shifting the blame on other people.
Amen.
And put the blame on ourselves.
Yep.
So if we love God,
mm-hmm,
nobody have to make you serve him.
Amen.
And if you love him like you say that you love him, then you'll use your talents,
uh-huh,
the way God give them to you.
Amen.
Am I right?
Amen.
Let me help us, girl.
Help.
When you have been sick,
mm-hmm, yeah,
in the hospital,
mm-hmm,
or laying in your bed of affliction at home,
mm-hmm,
and you know that what you've been through, it could not have been nobody else but the Lord who brought you through.
Amen.
And when you came through your sickness,
mm-hmm,
and you got well, and you know that it was God who blessed you, because can't nobody else do it like God can. So if we love him like we say that we love him, then you ought not mind serving him when you get the chance.
All right, all right.
So if you are saved, why do church people,
mm-hmm, come on,
forget what God has done for them?
Mm-hmm.
And let me remind us something. You cannot fool God.
Amen.
Because one thing about it, God knows your heart. When I was looking over in Galatians 6 and 7, it says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man soweth, that shall he reap. But I wonder, in this Christian journey, how much have we grown since we've been saved? And I began to look through the Bibles, and I looked over in Hebrew 5 and 12, and I looked at the NIV. And it says in the 12th verse, in fact, though through by this time, by this time, you ought to be teachers. Are you with me? You need, but yet still, you need someone else to teach you the elementary truth of God all over again. And he said, by this time,
mm-hmm,
we ought to be that groom just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
and but yet it's still, you need milk and not solid food. So I wonder, are we studying God's word? I wonder, are we praying and trusting in God like we should be? Watch this.
Come on.
Back in the disco music time, there was a song, we all know this song, Donna Summers started and she stated in the song, she said, enough is enough. And she said, I can't go no more. Are you with me?
All right.
So in other words, what Donna Summers was saying, that she had been in a relationship, that she finally saw that this relationship wasn't going nowhere. Have you ever been there before? She saw that it was time for her to move on. She saw that it was time to stop putting up with all of these heartaches and pains that she was going through. Are you with me? All of this misdirection and misinformation, it was time for her to say, enough is enough. And just like Donna Summers, there should come a time in our lives that we should see the devil for who he really is.
Amen. Amen.
The author of sin. We should see that the temple only purpose is to convince us against God's will. And can I, let me preach this. The devil, he is trying to bring us down and not let us get up. Mm-hmm. See, we need to shake the devil off. We need to put him under our feet. We need to take a stand and tell the devil, devil, enough is enough. So when we look at our text,
all right,
we find Jesus here, and what's happening here, Jesus is tired of the devil messing with him.
Amen.
And you see, if Jesus is tired, then we ought to be tired.
Amen.
And you see, I come to find out that the devil is always sticking his nose in business that he shouldn't be sticking it in.
Mm-hmm.
You see, I come to find out this, St. John, that we should be tired of the devil stealing our joy.
Amen.
Are you with me, church?
Amen.
We should be tired of him taking things from us.
Amen.
See, it looks like sometimes the devil will give you something, but he'll take it right back from you.
Mm-hmm.
And we should be tired of him trying to kill us as well as our family and our friends. Also, if you don't remember anything else I say in this message, remember that the devil will always try. I heard this, I heard Pastor Brown telling us this the other day. He will always try to give you something or convince you to do something for him so he can have power over you.
Mm-hmm.
Are y'all with me?
Mm-hmm.
That's why. That's why the song says, don't let the devil ride. If you let him ride, then he'll want to drive. Now we'll look back a few verses before our text over in the Gospel of Matthew 16 and 17 verse. And Jesus was baptized. And he went up straightway out of the water. And lo, the heavens opened unto him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon him. And then a low voice from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son, whom I well please. So after Jesus was led into the wilderness by the Holy Spirit, then the the devil came to him. After he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, Jesus was hungry and Jesus was tired. Can I preach this? And see, when you get tired and when you get hungry, that's where the devil will step in. After you had fasted, no food. Pray, no sleep. And change your ways, try to do right. Then the devil don't always step in. Remember the apostle Paul says over in Romans 7 and 21, he said, I find then a law that when I try to do good, then evil is always present with me. Uh-huh. See, when you try to do good, you got to look out for the devil. Amen. Amen. Because he comes to you at the weakest point that he catches you.
Amen.
Come on.
You see, I found out that it's time for us to say enough is enough. But let me tell you this here. If you are going to fight the devil, then you are going to have to be prepared. And if you are going to be prepared, it's going to have to come through God. 1 Corinthians 2 and 9, it said, but as it is written, eyes has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man that the things which God has prepared for those who love him. For those who love him. You can't fight the devil by yourself. Satan always will try to keep you, to get you to do something other than what you are supposed to do.
Right.
Hear me, church?
Right.
Watch this. He told Jesus to command these stones be made bread so he could feed himself. However, Jesus came back and said, it is written, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God. The devil will tell you to stop trusting God.
Let me help us with that.
He will tell every one of us to stop trusting God. If God loves you like he say he loves you, then he will allow you to go through some of the things that you're going through today. Are you with me? When he know without a doubt in his mind that the Bible teaches us to trust in the Lord and lean not to our own understanding. You see, it is time for us as children of God to start trusting in God. We see how these politicians and the government is doing. I'm going to try to help. I'm helping myself as this come out. When we see what they are doing in the White House said, if you be leaders, you'll fall for anything. Just try to make other folks happy. When the devil knows that, when he gets the parents to start allowing their children to do whatever they want to do and not what they had to go through. When the devil sees how these, they are doing with this gun control stuff. When the devil allows hate to come in rather than love. And his evil ways is using people to walk in a classroom and shoot our little children. Oh, I come to tell you, we ought to be saying enough is enough. And then secondly, we must be patient. Romans 15, it tells us 4 and 5, for whatsoever things were written before for our
And you see, I come to find this out, that when God is ready to promote you, the devil is always trying to get you to promote yourself. In other words, what he's trying to do, he's trying to get you to move before God tells you to move. And if you move before God tells you to move, then you're going to mess up. Watch this here. The devil, he took Jesus into the holy city. And he tells him to cast himself down. Because God won't let anything happen to him. You got to watch the devil. And then the devil had nerve, Brother Caesar, he had nerve to quote the scripture. He said, he shall give his angel charge concerning thee. And in their hands they shall bear thee up. Lest at any time thou dash thy foot against the stone. Oh, but Jesus went on. And he said, it is written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. You see, let me help you. When God get ready to promote you, when God tells you that you are going to be a saint, he tells you that you're going to be a deacon. It doesn't mean you got to go out and try to make the way plain for yourself. And the reason why, because a lot of times we want to say, look what I have done.
Oh, yeah.
Are you with me, church?
Amen.
Look at how he sing.
Amen.
And look how she sing.
Amen.
You see, we must remember and realize whatever gift we have is a gift that comes from God.
Amen.
My third point, and I'm done. We need to say enough is enough.
Amen.
Philippians 4:6, it said, be anxious for nothing.
Amen.
But in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God.
Amen.
Again, here we see here that the devil takes Jesus up into an even higher mountain and shows him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory thereof.
All right, yeah.
Then the devil tells Jesus, he said, all these things I will give thee if you fall down and worship me.
All right.
Once again, it's just like the devil to show you something that you already have. He's trying to give Jesus something that was already his. Stay with the church. God owns everything. Are you with me? When I looked over the gospel according to St. Matthew, the 7th chapter in the 7th verse, and it said, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Sometimes I learn this, thank you. We're going to have to learn how to pray and wait. Pray and wait. God also declares in Psalms 50:10, for every beast of the forest is mine, and the cattle and a thousand hills. God also declared in Haggai 2:8, he said, the silver is mine, and the gold is mine, said the Lord of hosts. And then David declares of God. In Psalms 24:1, he said, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwelleth in.
Amen.
You see what happened is, Satan's been telling us, and this is what I want to put in our mind. Satan's been telling us. He tells you Sometimes that you're never going to get well. When the doctor tell you you have some sickness, he's telling you that you'll never get well. He tells you you're going to stay sick the rest of your life. And here we are today. We start believing that stuff. He tells you that things are not going to get better for you. Can I help somebody today? God don't want us to stay sick. Are you with me, church? Satan will tell you that you will never be anything other than what you are. You will never be able to do any better. But I come to tell you today that God is saying enough is enough.
Right.
And look at what Jesus did. Jesus rebuked him. He said, enough is enough. He said, get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and give him only shall thou serve.
Amen.
So now I come this morning to let us know that Satan will try to get on the inside of you.
Well,
but what I'm trying to tell us is that we need to make sure that we stay prayed up.
Oh, yeah.
Are you with the church?
All right.
Well, you remember St. John.
Uh-huh.
When Satan whispers in the ear, and he tell you that you won't be able to make it.
Well,
are you with me, church?
Yeah.
But I come to tell you that you tell him now. The Bible says, blessed is a man that walk not in the counsel of ungodly, nor standeth in the way of the sinners.
Oh, yeah.
Are you with me, church?
Yeah, yeah.
And we got to learn on this Christian journey, we got to learn how to say enough is enough.
Oh, yeah.
Are you with me, church?
Yeah.
And I remember when I was growing up in a little small in Omaha, Texas.
Come on,
Doc. Am I right about it? And when I was growing up, I thought I knew everything. Am I right about it? And every now and then, my parents would tell me to do this and do that.
Well,
are you with me, church? But after a while, I kept on doing this and that, and I steadily kept on messing up. Am I right about it? And then after a period of time, there come a time when my mother and father, they would come to me and they would say, Freddie, enough is enough.
Well,
and you see, I went through some hard times and some bad times.
Yeah.
I began to learn that enough was enough.
Well,
am I right about it? And then I began to look over in the Luke's chapter, the 15th. And I found that the prodigal son, he got hot and he left home and he went out and he spent all of his money. He was righteously living.
Yeah.
Am I right about it? He was doing everything that he wanted to do. Am I right about it? And when he spent all his money, the Bible tells, they said a famine came in and he began to be in want. Am I right about it? Then he went to church to a country man now, and the country man sent him in the swine field. Am I right about it? They tell me while he was in the swine, he was there that he wanted to eat up all the slop the swines ate, because nobody would give him nothing. Am I right about it? But when he came to himself, he remembered that his father had hired servants. And the servants, my brothers and sisters, they had enough bread and they had some to spare. Am I right about it? But he was there, and the Bible lets us know that he perished with hunger. Am I right about it? They tell me that he got up and he went back where his father was. His father was waiting for him to come back home. Am I right about it? And I stopped by to tell you on my way to heaven, we're going to tell the devil enough is enough. Am I right about it? You got to tell the devil that you're not going to take this
stuff anymore, because the Bible tells us I'm more than a conqueror. I'm the head and not the tail. Am I right about it? Tell him that God has made you the lender and not a borrower. Am I right about it? If you had enough of the old devil put stuff all in your mind, you got to resist him and he'll flee from you. Am I right about it? I'm tired of having short one day and suffering tomorrow. Am I right about it? I'm gonna tell him, I'm gonna trust in the Lord until the day I die. Am I right about it? Weeping may endure for a night, but joy. Am I right about it? Look at him, look him straight in the eyes and tell him enough is enough. Am I right about it? When he tell you God won't forgive you for what you done, tell him we confess our sins. He's faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Am I right about it? When he get a little hard for you, tell him to look at the cross. Tell him that Jesus, he came down here over 2,000 years ago. Tell him he came to die for your sins, and he came to die for my sins. Tell him he carried the old rugged cross. Did he, church? Tell him they stretched him wide. They put nails in his hands and nails in his feet. Am I right about it? Tell him he died. He gave up the Holy Ghost. Tell them they placed him in a barren tomb. He lay there all Friday night. He lay there all Saturday night. But early, he got up. Did he get up? Anybody know he got up? When he got up, church, he had power. Power. Am I right about it? Tell the devil that enough is enough.
Amen.
I don't want my family.
Amen.
To go through what I already been through.
Yes.
If we don't tell our children, our grandchildren, our families, that enough is enough. Brother Cecil said today is getting closer than we think it is. Hello? The doors of the church is open. Jesus said, the day you hear my voice, harden out your heart. Tell the devil, enough is enough. St. John, we love God. You love God. It's time for us to tell Satan, enough is enough. We're going to start doing what God requires us to do as children of God.
We ask God to forgive us and we repent.
See, it's going to be a sad day when you stand before the Lord and you've been in the church all these years and then hear him say, depart from him. And when you see, when you get up at the age of we're our age, we all know that. It don't matter what you have done. God knows it all. He knows our whole life. He knows that he knows the numbers of hair on our head. Now why not just tell him, I am the son, Lord, and I need you to help me to live the life that he required us to live. If you there and you know you are out of fellowship with the Lord, this is your opportunity. Well, I come to church and I don't feel anything. I come to learn. I come to learn to get closer I can to God. I'm not going to come just to be coming. If you're out of fellowship, this is your opportunity now. While the blood is yet running warm, because we don't know what tomorrow may bring. We don't know the next 10 seconds what it might bring. Mm-hmm. God's a preacher. I mean, he didn't even miss a beat. And then he had a musician over here. And I thank God for you. You may be seated. Let's give our pastor a hand of praise. I was thinking, I said, boy, he got the new vision. He's going to need some help. But God stepped on in then because he didn't miss a beat. Amen. And thank God for using our pastor this morning. And I'm going to turn it back over to him. Yeah. Amen. We thank everyone for being here this morning. It's good to come and see our brothers and sisters. I don't like to do a whole lot of talking, but I don't know. I feel at home. This is my home. And everybody here, I love everyone here. I don't have nothing bad to say about nobody here. Because like I say, y'all took me in like a family. Amen. We're going to turn it back over to Pastor.
Amen. Let's all say amen.
Amen.
Reverend Bradford, I talked to Pastor Bradford before I come to one of those Sister Cox. So one of them passed away.
Her daughter.
I think her name was
Juanita. Okay. Yeah, that's what Reverend Bracken would tell the name. And so we're going to ask that we pray for them. Amen. And pray for that family, and I think they want to have service spirit, but we don't want to have service here. Amen. Because it's going to be on Saturday, but with all of this sickness coming on, and I don't want to do that, you know. And I talked to Pastor Bradford about that, but he'll let us know where they're going to have it at, and I'll try to let everybody know that also. Amen.
Amen.
But let us pray for them. That's another thing that we ought to start telling the devil enough is enough. Amen. Because all of us are going to have to stand before God. Amen. For what's over, we're going to stand before him. Any announcements? Anything you need about our attention? Yes, ma'am.
I have a church to keep my daughter in prayer.
Amen.
She's not completely out of the woods. She has a
Amen. And we will.
Yes, the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Yes, the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Yes, the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. Thank you, everyone. Something was said from this message that will be in our hearts when Satan, the devil, starts tempting us to do things which is not pleasing to your sight, that we'll be able to say enough is enough. Yeah. And if we resist the devil, we know that he'll flee from us from Caesar. Yeah. And God, we thank you. Thank God, we love you. Yeah. We pray that you bless our homes, bless our families, bless our loved ones, and then bless our enemies. We thank you, and we love you. All these COVID that's going around, we pray that you just bless all of us. Bless all of us and bless people everywhere. In the name of Jesus, would you please repeat these words after me? Much prayer.
Much prayer.
Much power.
Much power.
Little prayer.
Little prayer.
Little power.
Little power.
No prayer.
No prayer.
No power.
No power.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.